I try not to dwell too much on the mistakes of my past, of which there are many. I would go quite mad if I did that. But I do have one regret. The greatest misstep of my life. Made even more grave because it had dire consequences for someone else. Years ago, I was assigned as mentor to a lad, Anarin. He was my first apprentice. Anarin was an elf, raised in one of the elven alienages, and he was very mistrustful of humans, especially humans in authority. All he knew of the humans was what he had seen in the alienage. He was very wary of us. What Anarin needed was time. Time to get used to his new home, time to emerge from his shell, so we could build a rapport. I gave him no such time. I was young and arrogant. He is a mage, I thought. He needs to grow up and act like one. I expected too much from him, too quickly. I gave no consideration to his origin or his feelings, and he retreated further from me. All I could think of was how stubborn he was, how he was throwing away all his talent and his potential, just to be difficult. Oh, age and wisdom have mellowed me. I was quite different back then. Much more unforgiving. You cannot plant crops in the cold, wintry ground. You cannot teach a student who is closed off and unresponsive. Patience is what is needed, and I learned that too late to help him. Anarin ran away from the circle one night. I had berated him over some trivial, ridiculous matter that I no longer remember. I drove him away because of something utterly unimportant. He was a child, 14 at the time of his leaving. They had his phylactery, and they hunted him down. The phylactery is a vial of blood taken from a mage, but blood is connected to life. And your blood can be used to track you down. They called him Maleficar, a mage who practices forbidden magic, deserving of death. He was a child, misunderstood and lost. I begged the Templars to tell me if he suffered, if they gave him a quick death. I got no answers from them. I was his mentor, and they wouldn't even tell me what became of him. I should have known better. I had the best mentors. They were kind, compassionate. Why didn't I learn from them? I failed Anarin. All I had to do was listen to him. He would try to talk to me, and I would tell him to concentrate on his spells. He talked about the alienage sometimes, and the Dalish. He always talked about looking for the Dalish elf. The Templars are well-trained and thorough. That he still lives, it would be a vain hope. The apprentices that came after Anarin benefited greatly from the lessons I learned from him. In a sense, he was my teacher, and I his student. And there it is. My story, my one greatest regret.
Bueno, por lo menos. Vale.
You called. Speak then. Then I suggest we move on. As you wish.
A ver, este. Es que me recuerda a Stan.
Strange. I had almost forgotten it. Completion. Are you sure you are a Grey Warden? I think you must be an Ashkari to find a single lost blade in a country at war. I would thank you for this, I knew how. And I could deliver a much more satisfying answer to the Arishok's question if the blight were ended, don't you agree? I am one of the Beresad. I have never abandoned the field with a battle unmet. Indeed, it isn't every Grey Warden who has his own Beresad. I will see you reach the Archdemon. Lead the way.
Oh, vamos, ahora me quiere con locura. Mira, de hecho, si este se equipa el arma. La tengo. Sí, pues que se equipe, hombre. Pedazo de espadón. Madre mía. Bicho. Vale, pues ya hemos terminado un poco así. A ver si este le mejoro porque va descalcillo ahí.
Yes.
Indeed. Yes.
Vale, el risco y esto ya lo he hecho. Y me está diciendo ir aquí. Tenemos que ir a la choza de Flemeth. Voy a ir aquí. Tengo curiosidad. Ah, se quedó a la mitad. Ahora, cringe. Cringe. Madre mía. Para ahí al menos ya le estamos dando. Queda un enemigo.
That sustains me, so that it could lend us aid. I did not realize it would take this much out of me. It seemed a good idea at the time. If little rash. I think it may have weakened the spirit a little. Anyway, I feel quite all right now. And it seems that my little trick could be useful in a pinch. It's not a demon that requires controlling. Really, you need not fear it. I promise I'll be careful. And thank you. Your concern is touching.
Vale. Uf. Cuánta pasta. Lo vamos a forrar, chicos. Vale, aquí ya podemos irnos. Me sorprende, al final con tanto viaje, pues nos estamos haciendo todas las secundarias. A ver, es que quiero ver qué hay aquí. Esto es del DLC por narices. Sí, aquí está el hombre. Y hay una misión.
You'll have to forgive me if I seem a bit nervous. Not many people traveling in this part of Ferelden. Of course, that's part of my problem, isn't it? Neil got spooked by a wisp and ran off into the woods. Now what do I do? Well, yes. Oh, it's been quite the month. Allow me to introduce myself. Felix de Grosbois, merchant and entrepreneur at your service. I don't normally take this route, but with the war, I was hoping for a bit of luck and good weather in the mountains. Sadly, I've had neither. Ugh, this trip has been one miserable disaster after another. I don't suppose you consider helping a fellow out? Of all the other things that went wrong, the worst is this artifact I brought in Jada. It's a control rod, I'm told, for a golem. No point in me keeping it, however, as I'll never get to use it. But, maybe you could?
Just as well.
You'll find the golem in a village named Honleith, in the hinterlands. Here, I'll mark it on your map. I've heard it might be dangerous there with all the darkspawn about, but I'll wager that's not an issue for someone like you. Just hold up the rod and say Dulafgar. That will wake the golem up, so I'm told. I hope it works. Maybe you could look up the fellow who owned the golem before. If he's still about, that is. Best of luck to you then. Now, I guess it's up to me to find that mule myself.
Bueno, pues... a buscar un golem, ¿no? Que es aquí justo, Honleith. De hecho, no sé, me gustaría ir a Pico Soldado. Vamos a ir a estos bosques, tengo curiosidad. ¿De qué hay, claro? Vamos. A ver, venga. Sí.
Thank you. I didn't expect the band's men to notice my escape so quickly. I tried to hide here in the woods, but there wasn't time. And now I'm a dead man. You were there in Ostagar. You know how things went. For me, it was either this, die in some darkspawn's belly, or be hung as a deserter. You were there with the Grey Wardens. One of Duncan's new recruits. I was to guard the king. He was my friend, understand? Maker. All that time in Ban Loren's prison. And I couldn't stop thinking about all they suffered that one dark night at Ostagar. I know. Even had Loghain's men not turned their backs on us, the Darkspawn were too many. Even Caelan, for all his bravado, knew there would be no victory at Ostagar. The king entrusted me with the key to the royal arms chest. If anything were to happen to him, he said, it was vital I deliver it to the Wardens.
The royal arms chest. It's where Caelan kept his father's sword, the one he always said he'd slay the archdemon with.
More than that. There was a secret compartment where he kept documents concerning his dealings with Empress Selene and the Orlesians. He didn't get the chance. Duncan was so busy with the new recruits and keeping Loghain at bay. Whatever his reasoning, it's me Caelan entrusted it to. The Maker has a sense of humor, doesn't he? I suppose it's for the best, however. Had I kept it, it would be in Ban Loren's hands by now.
But you said Caelan entrusted it to you.
I was afraid. I thought I would lose it on the battlefield, so I stashed it in the camp. Please, it's probably still there. I hope not. Would they know how to work the lock, even if they did?
The Darkspawn are more cunning than we give them credit for. But the king trusted that lock with his secrets. I'd guess that the contents of that chest are still intact.
The key's behind a loose stone at the base of a statue. I'll draw a map for you, so you'll know where to search.
You'll be taking me along, won't you? Call me sentimental, but I left behind some Darkspawn that really deserve a sword through the middle.
The events at Ostagar still haunt my thoughts, Warden. If that is where we are headed, I would like to accompany you.
It is vital that the king's documents do not fall into the wrong hands. As for Marek's sword, it's too powerful to be pawed at by those monsters. Same for the king's other arms and armor. And if you happen to find Caelan's body, see it off. He was our king. He shouldn't be left to rot amidst the Darkspawn's filth.
Vale, esta es la otra parte del DLC. Retorno a Ostagar. Vale. Se ha activado esta. Vale, pues tenemos aquí varias de DLCs. Pero vamos a ir a Pico Soldado. Vamos a ir primero Pico. Luego vamos a ir a por este. Y luego ya vamos a Ostagar.
And here we are. Soldier's Peak. Maker's breath. Look at the size of her. What a fortress. I told you the map would get us through the tunnels. You wouldn't believe me if I told you. It came to me in my dreams. When I was a lad, I tried going through the tunnel by myself. Got horribly lost. But every now and again since, I've dreamt of it. I didn't want you to think I was some moon-addled simpleton. I've my wits about me. But enough of that. I'll follow you from a distance. This place has the stench of death. I expect there's trouble up ahead.
Soldier's Peak. Looks like it's seen better days. Better centuries, more like.
Vale, pues lo vamos a ir dejando por aquí. Espero que os esté gustando esta serie, chavales. La verdad es que he grabado bastante. Yo creo que me va a dar para muchos días. Así que si, bueno, veis que no he estado saludando hasta ahora y tal, ha sido simplemente porque ha estado pasando el tiempo. En fin, señores, espero que os haya gustado este capítulo y, bueno, estos episodios de la serie. Y nos vemos en un próximo. Así que nada, cuidaros y hasta la próxima. Adiós y Deus vult.